Hi everyone, Sean Dillman here. Welcome to your Walkthrough Wednesday. This is episode number 8. In this video, I'll be showing you how to get organized by using the calendar function in Microsoft Office as a to-do list. Jumping right in, if you already use Microsoft Outlook, you know that it's not just an email program and that it also has a very powerful and useful calendar function. If you use the Outlook app, you may also know that it does a great job of syncing with your smartphone so that you can always have your calendar handy and not be restricted to seeing it only when you're on your computer. Because of this functionality, the calendar in Outlook can be used as a really great to-do list. As a quick side note, this walkthrough has nothing to do with the tasks function in Outlook. Over the course of using Outlook for more than a decade, I've never known of anyone who actually uses it. I've tried it a few times myself, but I always found it to be a bit too clunky, and I found that keeping my to-do list in my calendar was a much better way to go. Also, this walkthrough is designed for either single users or people who are working with a small group or staff. If you need a solution for keeping tasks straight in a medium or larger sized organization, I'd recommend looking into Microsoft Planner, which is a visual-based software which is used to organize teamwork, plans, and tasks in larger groups. If you're interested in knowing more about Microsoft Planner, please just let me know and I can make it the subject of a future walkthrough. Okay, so here we are in the calendar in Outlook. Note these settings at the top, which give you the option to see a single day, a work week, a week, a month, or a schedule view. In general, I mostly use the week view because I also include personal items in my business calendar and certain events and holidays fall on weekends, and it's always good to be aware of these. So to start, I keep my tasks in Outlook calendar because all of my important meetings and events are already here. By keeping my information in Outlook, I can grant different levels of access to other people, such as trusted colleagues and staff who can help me with my tasks and events. For example, when I share my calendar with my assistant, she can see upcoming events and help me prepare for them. She can also see tasks and assist with those. For example, if I have a task that says draft retainer letter read Johnson file, and if my assistant sees this task, she may make a new Word document for this letter and start populating the letter with the client's name and address, as well as including the boilerplate language that I use for my retainer letters. If she does this, and let's say that her name is Sam, she can either let me know that she did it, or she can alter the event so that it says draft started by Sam in parentheses. If you find that you're completing many tasks on a regular basis and you already work with staff, you'll appreciate how helpful this can be. Okay, so how do I actually enter tasks into my calendar? I schedule them as all-day events. This means that they have no fixed start time or end time. For example, as you can see, I have a few tasks for this week scheduled on Monday, Tuesday, and Friday. The all-day events stay at the top of the section. This is helpful because my tasks will remain where I can see them in relation to what's happening during the days. It also helps me determine if I can defer tasks on my to-do list, and if so, where I can move them to. For example, let's say that today is Monday, and I'm wondering if I can defer this task, a call to make an appointment to change the oil in my car. If I'm still a few weeks ahead of my scheduled oil change date, no problem. I can move this item to Friday. Let's say that I'm also wondering if I can defer this task, to confirm my Zoom call with a new client. I can see that the call is scheduled for Tuesday morning, so I can't really defer this task, and I may need to simply do it today or get someone else to assist and do it for me. Here's another task on Tuesday, which is to prepare draft wills before meeting with the Browns on Thursday. Let's say that I'd like to defer this task to Wednesday. I can see that I have an all-day out-of-town court appearance on Wednesday, so maybe I don't want to defer drafting the wills because I can't make it work on Wednesday. I'll either need to complete the task or get my assistant to help with the task, or see about having the meetings with the Browns moved, if possible. As you can see, by using the calendar and Outlook in this way, you can schedule events and tasks in the same place, and be sure that you know that you have the time to complete the tasks in relation to your scheduled events and meetings. Another great feature of using this system is that it can double as a powerful record-keeping system, particularly for things that may not produce a paper or electronic record. For example, the following week, here on Thursday, let's say that I'm supposed to start taking a medication that's being prescribed by my doctor. I met with the doctor on Monday, and on Wednesday, I receive a phone call from the doctor's office asking me to start taking the medication on Friday instead of on Thursday. No problem. I can move the task over to Friday. Let's say that a year from now, I'm filling out an insurance questionnaire, and it asks me what date I started taking the particular medication. Although I likely won't remember the chain of events that occurred on this week, and there may be no record of the phone call, I'd see the task, start new medication, here on Friday, and this would tell me that I started taking the medication on that date. Occasionally, I encounter people who prefer to delete tasks from their calendar once they're complete, but in general, I err on the side of not deleting things, because keeping these kinds of events in your calendar can be part of a good record system. In my opinion, if you go to the trouble of making a task in your calendar in the first place, and if you complete it, you should just leave it on the date that you completed it. Also, it feels good to leave tasks in your calendar and see them as things that you've accomplished. To make all day events on your PC, double-click on this big area where it shows the number of the day in the month. To make all day events on your smartphone, you should see a plus symbol somewhere, either like this in the official Outlook app, or perhaps like this in a generic calendar app. Once the next screen comes up, ensure that the slider next to the words all day is activated. When you make your event, you can change settings such as color, priority, and when and if you'll receive a reminder. For me, I generally don't spend time making changes to the settings and find that the default settings work fine. I also don't spend time putting information into the location or notes fields. However, if you want to add notes, you can do that. Returning to my oil change example, if need be, I can include the address of the garage and include information about the last date that I had the oil changed and remind myself to ask them about changing the air filter. However, to really ensure that I don't forget this last part, I may simply add the note in the title of the task and include "also ask about air filter" in parentheses. On a final note, I should point out that using the Outlook calendar to manage to-do tasks is something of a hack, and it wasn't necessarily designed for this purpose. I make this point because I want you to realize that you need to be diligent in managing your all-day events if you follow my advice. Returning to my medication example, if I don't move the item to Friday, it's not going to move itself, and it'll simply stay on Thursday if it isn't moved. If I was using specific task management software, there would likely be a prompt to ask me if the task has been completed or not, and if not, it will stay on my to-do list until I've done it. When using Outlook Calendar as a task manager, once the day comes and goes, the task will stay on the day, even if you didn't complete it, unless you move it forward to a different day. However, for me, I rarely find this to be a problem, and if I ever find a task in a day in the past and I realize that I didn't actually complete it, I can simply drag it to a future date if I want to put it back on my to-do list. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video and found it to be helpful, please leave a like, comment, follow, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have an idea for a future walkthrough, please just let me know. Thank you very much to my friend Paul who suggested this video. Stay tuned for next week's episode, in which I'll be showing you how to save yourself from being interrupted and exert more control over your email communications by scheduling email delivery in Microsoft Outlook. As always, I'm Sean Dillman.